everyone, my name is Gargi Sarkar and I am welcoming you all to the desk of News Frontliner, and let's begin to the today's weekly news. News Frontliner web desk Kerala. On 16 December, massive success for the left in Kerala Panchayat elections. BJP has landed in fourth place. The people who lead the protest rally in different villages of Kerala has been elected. CPM candidates PP Divya Divya from Kaliaseri, Kannur district won with 22,430 votes majority. News Frontliner web desk, New Delhi, December 16th. Witnessing the tragic incident, the center of the farmers' movement, the Singhu border, a protester committed suicide on the spot of protest. According to his suicide letter, he shot himself in solidarity with farmers against three new agricultural laws. News Frontliner web desk caller, December 18. Released SFI leader Srikanto, member of SFI Karnataka State Committee and president of Kola Taluk. Srikant was arrested 2 days ago, December 15th at midnight, by Costa Police for hiding the violation of labor law in the Western incident while joining the protest in support of the demands of workers' movement KVET. News Frontliner web desk sports desk. December 18, a Switzerland court on Thursday cuts Russia's 4-year ban on global sports to half. The decision that could indicate the end of its long-term war with anti-doping regulators accused of running one of the most modern doping schemes in history. News Frontliner breaking, 18 December. On that day morning, the former principal of Ranaghat College doctor went to the house of senior CPM leader Tirathbharan Topdar, and Paresh Chandranath withdraws 25,000 rupees to the Mass Power Fund. News Frontliner web desk, Purva Bardhaman, 19 December, late Abdul Rizak Mandal Memorial Meeting at Galsi Paraj. The party's state secretary Surjakanta Mishra, the party's central committee member Madan Ghosh, the party's former Bardhaman district secretary Achinta Malik presided over. At the beginning of the commemoration meeting, the late Abdul Rizak Mandal's portrait was paid respect with a garland. Abdul Babu is remembered in the presence of many people. News Frontliner web desk Khazuri, December 19. After a long 11 years, the Trinamoolis vandalized the CPIM office of Kamarda Bazar in the Kamarda region of Khazuri. The rest were seized. Yesterday, the office was reopened in the presence of the people of the locals, laborers, farmers, field laborers with red flags of the CPIM branch office and opened their own offices. Led by the state committee member Himanshu Das, district committee member Jadvendra Sahu and area committee secretary Gokul Garai, Gauri Jana, Amya Acharya, Sheikh Mustaka, Samir Kala and many others who know the laws. 19 December, Belkulai Sri Ramakrishna Maa Sharada Sevashram has come forward for the eye examination of the people in that area. A free eye examination camp was held on Saturday at Vasudevpur Ulberia 2nd number block and Raghudevpur with their initiative and the help of Haldia Chaitanyapur Vivekananda Mission Ashram. The context is that from now onwards the patients who are in the eyes will be taken to that Chaitanyapur Eye Hospital Haldia for free. News Frontliner breaking, tragic road accident in Durgapur Makura State Road. They returned. A cyclist in Durgapur Sagarbhanga died. The locals alleged that the traffic police are busy taking money from the trucks which often caused accidents. The locals blocking the long routes. News Frontliner breaking, 18 December. Kastia is called the cultural show of Bangladesh. That Kastia has also become the place of communal mall bus. The sculpture of Bangabandhu has been broken in Kastia. Now, the sculpture of one of the revolutionary hero, Bagha Jyotin of the anti-British movement has been broken in Kastia. 19 December, youth leader stood beside a woman in doubt of life for blood. She donated blood on Saturday in the hospital bed. The incident took place on Saturday at Kalna Super Speciality Hospital. For a long time, this hospital has been having a severe blood crisis. The reason for this blood crisis, sometimes corona atmosphere, sometimes lack of blood testing. Again in the present time, the atmosphere of changing parties. Shikha Gog, a resident of ward number 17 of Kalna municipality, was admitted to Kalna Super Speciality Hospital with liver problems. The concerned doctor said for the blood as she has a shortage of blood in her body. News Frontliner breaking, December 19. Severe cold flows across Bihar with 3.6 degrees Celsius temperatures and 2 days alert in parts of Bihar. News Frontliner web desk Balurghat, Sushant Kundu, 19 December, South Dinajpur District Forward Block held a protest rally in Balurghat on Saturday demanding the abolition of agricultural law. On this day, the procession came out of the Balurghat public bus stand and roamed around the entire Balurghat city. 20 December, Republic TV broadcast a false news on Kishan movement. Reporter faces the protest in Gajipur border. News Frontliner Web Desk, Chhattisgarh, 20th December, tribute meeting continues for protesting martyred farmers in Delhi across the state. Kishan Sabha said that these laws should be stopped until the validity of agricultural laws are tested. All Indian Kishan Samboy Committee and Joint Kishan Morcha on nationwide call, the tribute meeting for the martyrs of the farmers' movement in Chhattisgarh continues from this morning and the program will be continued till night. 20th December, BJP's rally in Pondicherry. Farmers are in the face of blocking the processions in support of agriculture law. 20th December, West Tripura Kharpur heated up in the clash between CPM and BJP. Here I am ending the weekly news of News Frontliner. Thank you.